the mid stage, ultimately wasn't able to convert it. Mm-hmm. But we'll go now into...
Absolutely, yes. Lucario and Hero. Now, I am so sad that we don't actually get to see the Ditto. I really want to see the Ditto. I love the Ditto. Well, I love Dittos just in general. I think Dittos are so cool. But, you know, Vivi does also play Hero. But we have Silvio, who also plays Hero. Now, this is definitely going to be a very weird matchup. I think Vivi right now, Wow, being the ultimate aggressor right here, just getting that very nice combo string. I think that, you know, Vivi is going to have to be the aggressor in a lot of these situations. And, you know, as much as people think that Lucario doesn't want to be an aggressor, Vivi does really well at just, you know, putting on a lot of pressure when they need to. And this is just where we're going to start seeing that pressure here. Already at 82%, and now all Vivi, all Vivi really needs is a good read like that. And they're going to take that first stock from Silvio.
And Vivi, playstyle very much, you'll see it a lot here, is very good at getting into a danger range and then coming right back out of it, whether that be with a wave bounce neutral B, whether that just be jump in, come back, whether that be cross over you. It's very difficult to tack Vivi down, and it's very scary because of Lucario's aura. So you need to try to have some sort of conversion that kills, or you need to take care of them before they get too much aura, because then it's very scary. Because if you mess up once, then Vivi kills you.
Absolutely. And the thing that I want to take note of as well is that, you know, this is a very, this is also just very good from Vivi on, you know, just this alone, is with the simple fact that as a playstyle, Silvio has a really good defensive game. You know, whenever you're just kind of like playing in neutral and you're being very aggressive, they tend to have really good, you know, defensive options out of shield. They have jab, they have up B, and they actually take so much off of it. They, like, once they actually get back into, you know, like, advantage from being in a very, you know, the defensive position, they take that for how, you know, they, like, they just take it so far. Mm-hmm. But what we're seeing right now is just Vivi really invading that space and, you know, just kind of understanding what Hero wants to do.
Yeah, it's very difficult because Hero's frame data is a little bit on the slower end. So Vivi, we're seeing a lot of occupation of that space where, oh, I could hit your Hero right now. What are you going to do? And essentially creating an uncomfortable scenario where Silvio has to make a choice and take an option and a commitment or otherwise potentially get hit. So, all right, not dead on that one. We're going to see an Accelerado chase. Tornado cover the ledge on that one.
That was very nice, too. And the one thing that I also want to talk about is that Silvio does, they really place their up B so well when they actually want to edge guard. It covers so much of a big, like, range that people actually need in order to, like, kind of, you know, recover, and they're actually going to take that stock with that side B right there. Mm-hmm. But again, getting into this game, Silvio, it is in a very bad spot here. They are two stocks down, and it only took about like two really good reads on their like jumps in for, you know, Vivi to actually get a stock like that thing he was just trying to do there. But very nice from Silvio, actually, you know, kind of just taking note of what actually killed them those first two games, and just, you know, making really good, like, note of that.
Yep, and I'm liking the rep of the lightning here as well. So that, when it calls down the Thunderbolt, that can potentially get called down on a projectile. So if Vivi sends out Aura Sphere, that lightning will call down and still send outwards and potentially hit Lucario. So it's a very safe option. It does use up MP if you go for it a lot. Oh, no, man, death back here.
Absolutely.
But we saw, I would say Silvio was doing pretty well on the defense on that one. It is very difficult because Vivi does like to get right in your face and like come right up to you and then make you flinch. Vivi's very good at that. So we see it like that, like the fadeaway forward smash on that one. We see these jump back, put out the back air, and it's got a real big hitbox, especially with the aura. We see all these options that are pretty safe. And then we see the catch with the up smash on that as well. Very tempting for Heroes to jump a lot with Accelerado because they're so quick. A lot of options here. Yeah, that one's tough too. Punishing that up B is tough.
Something that I definitely would like to see a little bit more from Silvio is to actually use a lot of their other tools. You know, when it comes to actually having people to break your defensive options, very nice up B there, just calling that, you know, just run in. When it comes to reading people's defensive options, you need to know where they're going to be when they land. So the thing that I want to see is actually Silvio just wait for, you know, Vivi to actually approach. Just wait at where he's going to approach with, you know, Nair. And since Nair is minus two, it doesn't matter if, you know, you're just trying to read it as a landing option or at a shield. Mm-hmm. You kind of just want to be at that space when they actually do land.
Yeah, I mean, it's scary, though, because, like I said, it's you have the double jumps, you have the B reverses with Aura Sphere that make it very difficult to pin Vivi down. And Vivi doesn't make too many commitments in your face. It's a lot of, like, fadeaways. So if you do look for a landing, especially with Hero, who has a lot of commitment on a lot of moves, it could end up like, oh, I'll do a forward tilt, I'll do a Nair, I'll do a forward air or something, and then Lucario's there for the whiff punish, which is what Vivi banks on.
To that note, the thing with Vivi is that, you know, Vivi isn't just like, you know, he doesn't have to use, you know, his wave bounces and whatnot. The thing is that when he does that, he's looking for, you know, what his opponent wants to do right there. You know, he kind of just threw that in his face, you know, canceled it, ran, and, you know, got that or that force bomb to actually take that first stock. Now, this is definitely where we're going to see Silvio struggle a little bit more, only because, you know, they haven't really showed that they have a consistent way of getting the kill on Vivi.
Nice. That was a good forward air. Hop over the Aura Sphere. Very nice timing on that by Silvio. It is a little bit scary with Lucario at the Aura percents, but Lucario's also not too heavy, so a good... Even that'll do it, honestly. Yeah. And Hero is not lacking for power in their areas as well, so you'll see
absolutely.
A lot of that.
Now, honestly, what I feel like is just happening here is that this is just a very even game. Maybe not so much even anymore because Silvio has 65% on them. Now, this is just kind of crazy. What's kind of just Vivi, I really like the aggression, honestly. I just have to mention that again. Vivi is just not really getting or letting, you know, Silvio get to do the things that, you know, we've definitely seen from them. Just never giving them too much space and reading a lot of their aggressive, I mean, their more so aggressive options to actually kind of just get back into a more neutral position.
Mm-hmm. Yep. It's very difficult for that to work out, especially at a... It's not too big of a deficit right now, but when you're off stage against Lucario, it's like, okay, you know, if I trade back to stage and Lucario gets a little bit more aura on this one, how can I get them off me, potentially convert into an edge guard or a ledge trap scenario, something that can get this kill earlier. Although that back throw might be a good start for that. All right.
Now, ooh, that is actually going to take that stock. Now, this can be very scary for Silvio. This is their winner's, you know, life stock that they have, and if they can't really find a way to actually, you know, take the stock, then they are going to find themselves in loser. So we definitely need to see something happen here. Going to have that air dodge, and just Vivi is doing really well at just not letting, you know, Silvio have any time to actually think about what's going on here.
Yep, Silvio is getting put in a lot of mix on this one, although we are seeing the charge fireball option. Oh, no. Committed once more to the jump up side B, potentially good option to catch something like an Aura Sphere or if they're coming too close for an edge guard on that one. But getting hard punished by the force bomb on that.
Absolutely. So that was a very good showing in from, you know, Vivi. And the thing about that is that we see a lot of these zoners and all of these people with like really good like B moves that were just like, you know, you wouldn't expect them to kind of approach, but that's just really one good case of just Vivi kind of being a really good playing the aggressive game, honestly. Mm-hmm.